Hello, peeps. Welcome to another episode of Creativerse. In this episode, the Pumpkiru's candy campaign is still continuing on. And we have, the community has smashed the 1.5 million idle mark that was needed to get the highest treasure. And so in this episode we are going to open those treasures up and see what kind of goodies we all get. So I actually have both of these two, the Candy Thief Accolade, to open up, and the Ultimate Candy Thief Bounty to open up, which is down here. So first, plus I have all of these login bundles. So first things first that I want to do is let us find somewhere to just dump our current inventory, so we have it, so we can get a better idea of what we all have and what we all get. Definitely from all of these login bonus chests, we're definitely accumulating a nice stack of super extractors. Which is pretty awesome. I also have three of these Pumpkiru's King Treasure, which you know what? We're just gonna dump all of it in there. So the only thing we have, which are ones that you can buy, get from Pumpkiru. For the candy, by trading the candy, and these ones were all of the level 100 trades. So let's start with those. Open the first one and see what we get. We got Haunted Stone Wall and a good variety of some of the other stuff. So let's open the second one. Oh, we got the Scare Flare recipe. I wonder if I already know that one or not. And open the last one. And another Haunted Stone Wall. I am curious if I know this one or not. I didn't. Now I do. I knew that one. Alright. Let's grab that back. This one back out. And let's just place it right there. And I want to dump this stuff off. So this was the stuff that I got from Pumpkiru. And let's do the Candy Thief Accolade. So we're getting another one of these and some more Pumpkiru candy. So we might have to go search for Pumpkiru again. Start with, let's see which one's Royal Pumpkin Treasure. I'm gonna guess that the chest is, actually I think the chest is actually a chest. That would make sense. So that's actually an item. These ones are actually chests that give us something. a haunted pumpkin. I wonder if I have that one. The other thing we're getting a really good stock of is flaming skulls. So we likely won't have to make any fire bombs for quite a while. Unless they change them somehow. There's 29 more. Haunted roof. I'm pretty sure I know that one because I crafted a whole bunch of those making my house. And haunted. 28 more flaming skulls. Alright, so the last one out of this group is one of these Pumpkiru's King Treasure. And another haunted stone wall. Alright, so do we know? We know that one. We know that one. That one. And we actually know the pumpkin too. Alright, so this time let's place. Let's place these items in a royal pumpkin chest. So that was the candy thief accolade. So now we have the ultimate candy thief bounty, which is supposed to give us Pumpkiru's King Chest, Candy Skull Banner, Candy Skull Statue, Yellow Candy Skull Candle, Blue Candy Skull Candle, Red Candy Skull Candle, Candy Skull Candles, 3 of the Pumpkiru's King Chest, and 5 Royal Treasures plus more, so... we will claim that bad boy and place it down. So we get 100 more candy, so we definitely are going to have to go find Pumpkiru. And out of curiosity, are these any bigger? Oops, I pushed the wrong one. What I was curious about was, is it these ones? Let's make sure. No, it's these. These are the chests. They actually look really cool. And actually they are bigger. So these ones are 40. These ones are both 36. So this one actually is bigger, so we'll set that one there to put all of this stuff in. So let's continue opening these up. Haunted door, pretty sure I know that one. I know all of the regular holiday recipes. It's any new ones that they added that I won't know. Out of curiosity, let's take a peek down. I think they should all be listed somewhere in the bottom. Okay, so I still don't know. This one, the flaming skull. The Vladerang. So there's two there that I don't know. Those are the only two I don't know. So hopefully we get lucky and get those out of one of these Pumpkiru King treasures. Oh, it's a haunted door. Alright, we got the flaming skull. Good deal. All we need now is the Vladerang. Can we get lucky and get the Vladder? Yes, we did. Perfect. So we've unlocked all of the Halloween recipes. We got another Vladerang. And a haunted grave stone shard, you know. So and dump all of this stuff in here. Except for a flaming skull and the flattering. Because we're going to read that and read that. Which is enough to go get two more treasures from Pumpkiru. But we need to grab some healing items, or else. We could end up in trouble. Really don't need any of that stuff with us. Well, maybe. Let's just grab the bombs. Alright, so taking a look quick, this is what we got from the treasures. I guess you could pause it if you want to see just kind of what we all got. 73 of the flaming skulls. And then this is what we got from the candy thief accolade. That's 153 flaming skulls. A few of these marigold potions. And obviously quite a few of the building blocks. And then this was the last one, which was the ultimate candy thief bounty. And this one we have 210 flaming skulls. And a couple of the... Again, you can pause it if you want to see closer what we all got. Actually, what I want to do... What I'm going to do now is just throw all of this together. Now that I've kind of taken a peek at everything. And basically have shown you what everything that we got. We will go ahead and just pick all of this up. Here. Now, I have gotten some of these flame-resistant potions from this event, but... Let's just place one of these cool-looking chests down here. And dump as much of this in there as I can. Enough for all of it. So we'll place down this last one. Store the remaining chests in that one. Alright, and one last thing. Still wouldn't give me enough space for all of them. But I threw my pumpkin, my candy in there. One last quick thing is let's claim all of these login bundles. I've saved up quite a few of them. Super extractors down to the corruption layer and get us a good amount of lumenite. Alright, so that's the last one. So we ended up out of those, we have 29 arc stones, 52 more idols, 88 super extractors, and 20 flares, and then I'm sure there was some of these were in there too. So let's put the flares in this one. Arc stones in this. We built up a decent amount of arc stones too. We're up to 214 super extractors, which is really nice. And we still have a number of these idols. Now, I don't know if these idols will do anything after the Halloween event is done. And I don't know if they've... I don't think they've announced when the Halloween event is going to end. So let's go, let's sleep really quick, make it be nighttime so we can go look for, oh man, it slept us right through the nighttime. I was gonna say, boy, it's light out for being nighttime. Alright, so now it's nighttime. So I'll try to find Pumpkiru. It's usually pretty easy to... Oh, there's a treasure chest. I wanna grab that. Recipe. So what we're doing is looking for pumpkiros that will take 100 coin or 100 candy traits. Let's see this red bed. No, I must already know. And a blue bed. That was a pretty decent treasure to have both of those recipes in it. I think there's really only a couple treasures that or recipes that I don't have in it yet. This one's 50. Hold out until we find a 200 one. Also kind of on the lookout for a new location. I've decided that I want to move. Nothing against Onyx Gem. I'm not moving because of you. I just want to I have this idea of like kind of not necessarily totally themed area, but a fairly decently themed area, and making these protective walls all the way around the whole area, and the area that we're in right now just kind of isn't going to work very well for that. So I'm kind of on a lookout for a new location for that. I kind of want to build like a big village type place with multiple buildings and potentially maybe even some type of big castle in the center of it, or at least inside of it somewhere. Whether or not that's a castle that I build on my own, or if it's a castle that, if it's the blueprint castle, because I have not made one of those yet, and I still would like to make one of those for a video of doing that castle build. What are you? You're a Pumpkiru Jr. I've never seen you. What's he do? We want to take a good screenshot of him. Oh, come on. Let me... Come on. I can't interact with him. So he sells stuff just like Big Pumpkin does. I really want to get a better screenshot with him. But I'm getting guessing I'm gonna run out of time. Stop and look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Please. Please. Or stop there. I might be able to get a decent one. Ah, come on. Don't be camera shy. Okay. Stop right there. No. Stop. Maybe. Come on, we're running out of time. Whoa. Shot of him on fire pretty soon. What the heck is he doing? Alright, let's I guess I'm gonna have to hope that some of those were good enough. Let me fix this mess back up that I made. Hasn't burned up because he's in the water. Sorry, I burned him up. Oh, sorry, little guy. All right, so I kind of got distracted there and kind of missed out on looking for the rest of some other Pumpkiru's. I never seen the little baby one. I didn't know there was such a thing. Little junior. I do not have a bed or anything with me, so in order to get more, I'll have to sleep. So for now, I'm just going to end this episode here. Wanted to take a look and see what kind of goodies we were going to get out of those treasure chests from the community event. And we did a little bit of exploring and ended up finding Junior. So please remember to hit the like button if you liked what you saw, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And I will talk to everybody later. Bye now.